start in child's pose, like so. Hello.
Release your forehead down.
Breathe into your back body. And of course, if child's pose doesn't feel good, this is exactly when you get to decide that you want to do something else instead. And as you are breathing in child's pose, feel your breath start to even and level. With your next inhale, just rise up onto your forearms and just set your knees where it feels comfortable. You can lace your hands or you can have your hands at shoulders distance apart, whatever those things are that are on top of your arms. And we're gonna do cat and cow with your forearms down on the ground. That might feel a little bit almost like limiting. Good morning, come on in. In the sense of when your arms are straight, you have a greater range of motion. Typically, it feels that way.
This is a little more isolating.
Kind of shorten the lever of the body. Good morning. One more round here. And then bring your elbows forward. Bring your hands together in prayer, and you're going to do the same thing. Do cat and cow with your elbows down. Keep your feet active. Next time you drop your heart through toward the ground, like cow, you're going to pause here. Maybe bring your chin or your forehead toward the floor. Maybe slide the elbows forward a little bit more and the heart starts to work toward the floor, but it might not yet. We're just like freshly moving here, so don't push it too quickly. Yes, gorgeous, beautiful. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, yes. Bring the arms around. Bring your hands under your shoulders. Tuck your toes. Come into plank. And then push the ground away. Like really push the ground away with your hands, with your feet. Spread your shoulder blades wide on your back. Firm your legs. Always, if this feels like too much, you just bring your knees to the ground lightly. Really nice. Good. Nice, Denise. Really good. Mm-hmm. One more inhale. Your exhale brings you back into downward facing dog, heels pressing back, ears drop between your biceps, top of the head, like the top of the ears, top of the head, stretch toward your thumbs. Inhale, lift your heels high. Drop your heels to one side, it doesn't matter which one. And then maybe bend the knees and straighten the legs a couple times. Mm-hmm.
Come back up to center, high toes, and then drop the heels to the other side. And then do the same thing, maybe bend the knees, and then straighten the legs. Keep pushing the arms really firmly, beautiful. Yes, 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 yes. Mm-hmm. Come back through center, and then heels press back and down. Energize your hands, your feet, and the floor. Really feel your foundation points. Mm-hmm. Good. Right leg back with your inhale. And then knee down the center, right foot to the ground. Left knee comes down. Bring your right hand onto your right thigh. Nice. And then if you want, bend the back leg, but don't take the foot. Just try to pull the heel in and then use your right hand on your right thigh to twist open. Good. If you're new to me and you just came in, I'm Maeve. If you have anything going on in your body that you want me to know about, call me over. Good. Beautiful. Yes, yes. Good. You're going to take this left foot over toward the right. Yep, perfect. And you're going to slide your right arm onto your forearm, and you're going to open up in a version of side angle. Yep. If it feels good, you can slide your hand to the floor, but there's no rush to get there. That would be your right hand to the floor. Helps if I say which one. Beautiful. Really nice. Good. Press into your right foot. Rise up. Straighten that right foot out. Take your arms up to the sky, take a big breath in, and then bring your hands to your hips. Good. You can change these right toes however you need to. Just take a little back bend here. It might help if you turn them forward. You might feel good where it is. Yes, beautiful. Inhale, reach back up. Bend your right knee, bring your hands around top of the mat. Step back, plank. Breath in plank, lower to your belly, exhale. Slide your forearms forward. Sphinx, hands pressing down, forearms pressing down. Toes, tops of the feet pressing down, and then draw the shoulders back energetically, the forearm back energetically. Last inhale. Release with your exhale. Tuck your toes. Press up and back, downward facing dog. Pause for a breath. Inhale, left leg back. Exhale, knee down the center. Place your left foot forward. Right knee comes down. Left hand onto your left thigh. Good. And then maybe bend the back leg, but you're not taking the foot. You're just twisting open and pulling the foot energetically toward your hip. Yes. Good. Good. Yes. Good. And then turn your right foot over to the left. Arm slides onto your thigh on the left side. Beautiful. Opening up here. Good, good, good. Maybe your left hand slides down to the ground. Beautiful. Nice. Good, James. Yes. Press into your left foot. Rise up with your inhale. Take the arms up to the sky. Get a big expansion. Pull your low belly in just a bit, and then bring your hands to your hips and the back of your hips. And then just opening up like you're going into camel. Yep. Yes. Inhale, reach back up. Exhale, come around top of the mat with your hands. Tuck your right toes, step back to plank, breath in. Lower to your belly. Hands go wide, about a ribcage height or level. Not height, but level. Hug the elbows back, curl the heart up. If it feels good, maybe go side to side a little bit here. Yes. Beautiful. You've got one more breath, come through center. And then downward facing dog with your exhale. Smooth, steady breath. In and out through the nose. And if you're comfortable with Ujjayi and you haven't yet cultivated Ujjayi breath, it's a little bit of a, but with your mouth closed. And you reverse that. With the inhale, you're drawing back. High to your toes, inhale. Bend your knees deeply. Look at your hands, lock, step, or jump your feet to your hands. Come up halfway with your inhale. And fold with your exhale. Push the ground away, inhale, rise to stand. Sweep your arms to the sky. And then draw your hands into your heart with your exhale. Just your breath and your arms. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, hands to your heart. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale. Hold back to your chest to thighs. Inhale, rise up to stand. And bring your hands into your heart. Exhale. So we're just building rhythm. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bow forward. Beautiful. Halfway, inhale. Hold back down, exhale. Rise, inhale. Yes. Bring your hands into your heart. Exhale. One more like that. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bowing forward. Inhale, halfway. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bowing forward. Come up halfway with your inhale. Step your right foot to the back of your mat. Bend your front knee. Crescent pose coming up here. Take a breath in. Release your hands to the ground. Plank breath in. Belly down. Hug the elbows in and back. Cobra. Tops of the feet press down. Curl up. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Beautiful. Inhale. Right leg stretches back. Knee into your chest. Place your right foot forward. Crescent pose. Rise up. And then exhale, bring your hands forward, step to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway. Bow forward, exhale. Rise, inhale. Bring your hands behind your hips, exhale. Lace your fingers, inhale, heart to sky. And then bow forward. Release your hands down. Come halfway, inhale. Left foot steps back, exhale. Crescent pose, inhale. Hands down, exhale. Plank, inhale. Lower to your belly, exhale. Cobra, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Beautiful. Left leg back, inhale. Knee into your chest, place your foot forward. Crescent, rise up. Hands down, step forward. Halfway, inhale, fold, exhale, rise, inhale, hands into heart, exhale, inhale, rise up, exhale, bowing forward, inhale, halfway, step back, right foot, inhale, crescent, consider lifting that left heel up. And then release your hands down. Step back, plank. Lower to your belly. Cobra. Downward facing dog. Right leg stretches back. Right foot steps forward. Crescent pose, inhale. Maybe lift up that right heel. And then hands and feet top of your mat, forward fold. Lengthen halfway. Fold down with your exhale. Rise, inhale. Hands behind the hips, exhale. Engage your glutes, heart to sky, inhale. And then bow forward, exhale. Halfway, inhale, release your hands. Left foot steps back. Crescent, inhale. Consider picking up that right heel, the front heel. And then hands come down. Plank, inhale. To your belly, exhale. Cobra. Downward facing dog. Yes. Left leg stretches back. Left foot comes forward. Crescent, consider picking up that front heel. And then hands and feet top of your mat. Lengthen halfway. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. And hands into your heart, exhale. Beautiful. Rise up, inhale. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale. Step to plank. Breath in and plank. Bend the elbows, either lower to your belly or come halfway for chaturanga. And then inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Downward facing dog with your exhale. Beautiful. Keep your breath steady. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, look forward, bring your feet up to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Hold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Bend your elbows out to the side, exhale. Lift your heart, inhale. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rise, yes. Downward facing dog, exhale, well done. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Hold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Heart lifts, elbows bend. Inhale, and then exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale, chaturanga, exhale. Inhale, rise up, good, yes, Becky. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale, heels high. Exhale, knees bend, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale, hold, exhale. Rise, inhale, and draw your hands to your heart, exhale. Chair, inhale, bend your knees, beautiful. Yes, 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 good, good, yes, yes, so good. Hands come down, don't go anywhere. Take your hands a good 8 to 12 inches in front of you. Lift your heels up and bring your knees onto your triceps, but you're not going to go anywhere. You're going to pick up your right foot and then put it down. Pick up your left foot and then put it down. And think cat's pose in your back. So round that upper back, pull the belly in like you're in cat's pose. Yes. Yes. Beautiful. Good, Jackie. You got it. I see you. Like, can I not do this? You can not do it. Remember, everything's optional. Good. Pause, pull your heart forward, and then chaturanga. Take it back. Move through to downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg stretches back. Come really high into your left toes, and your right knee up to your tricep. And then see if you can tap your wrist with your right toes. Yep. Inhale, up and back. It's ridiculous, I know. Cross over to the left. Tap the elbow. Inhale, up and back. And then exhale, place your foot forward. Back knee comes down. Right hand to the sky. Option to take the back foot this time. You can kick the foot gently into your hand. Yep. James, switch your hands if you can. No, your foot is perfect. Your foot is perfect. Bring your other foot forward. Yeah, there you go. Good. So we're going to do a lot like what we did in that very first kind of sequence. You're going to bring this left foot over to the right and come into modified side angle. So right arm on your thigh, your right hand at the floor. And then push into the right foot, rise up. Good. Straighten the right leg as much as you can and then reach the right arm up, maybe left hand comes to your heel. It helps if I'm in the right spot. And then lift the heart, so like a half camel. Inhale, rise up. And then bring that left hand around. Left foot goes back. Pivot to the pinky side of your left foot. Come into Vashisthasana. Yes. You can put your left knee down. Yep. Beautiful. Yes.
Cause sister, you don't need them. And I ain't trying to gas you up. I just call it how I see.
Take another inhale. Come to plank in the center and exhale, lower down. Rise. Up dog or cobra. Down dog. Exhale. Left leg back. Inhale. Left knee, left tricep. See if you can tap your left wrist with your toes. So find that cat's pose in the spine. Inhale, stretch back. And then cross over, tap the right elbow. Knee twist. Inhale back. And then place your left foot forward. Right hand stays down on the ground. Left hand sweeps up. Maybe find the right foot with your left hand. I know you fed up, ladies. Yeah. But keep your head up. Things are gonna get easier. Ooh, child, things will get brighter. And then come around. Right foot kicks over to the left. Left hand down on the floor or arm on your thigh. Modified side angle. Yes, good. And then push into that left foot. Good, rise up. Good, left arm up. You can have your right hand on your hip or maybe that right hand comes back to the right heel. So nice, Suzanne, beautiful. Nice, Kristen. Inhale, rise up. Come around top of the mat with your hand. Pinky side of the right foot down. Right hand, and then Vashisthasana. There's so many versions of this pose. You can find whatever one works for you today. Come through center, chaturanga. Rise, open the heart, and down dog, exhale. Good, good, good. We meet again, good friend. You see the stars come down to meet you. Inhale, lift the heel. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale, and hold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Stay in chair, bring your hands behind your hips. Lace the fingers, heart to sky. And then bow forward, straighten the leg. You're going to do that a couple times. Inhale, chair, keep the arms here. And then exhale, forward fold. So you're going to keep the arms if it's okay. And just move through the hips and the legs. Inhaling. And exhaling. Couple more. One more time. Share with your inhale. Yes. Forward fold with your exhale. Release your hands around. Stretch the hands forward. Lift your heels. Bend your knees. Get your knees up toward your triceps. So you can be here again, picking up one foot, and then the other foot. Maybe you find both feet just float up, heart forward. Find cat's pose in your back. Big toes touch if you can.
Yes, beautiful. You've got it. There it is, Becky.
And then make your way back into chaturanga or just down dog. You don't have to go through vinyasa. Inhale, glide forward to plank. Lower to your belly. All the way down. Yep. Belly down. Right elbow out to the side. Good. You're gonna roll onto your right side. Stack your hips. Stack your feet. Good. Good. If you want, bend your top leg, your left leg, and put it on the ground behind the right leg, but you don't have to. Come back through center. And then left side. Take the left elbow out to the side. Look to the right. Stack the hips, stack the feet. Yes, yes. Option to bring that right foot to the ground here. Good, Tom. Come back through center, and then Sphinx pose here, a little pause here. Heart draws through. Draw the belly up away from the ground, so lengthen out your low back. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Yes. I only miss you when the elbows go wide, tuck your toes downward facing dog. Is my favorite sound, swaying like the palm trees. Inhale, right leg stretches back. Right knee, right tricep. Tap the wrist if it's there for you. Inhale, come back. Cross over. Extend your right leg up to the left. Turn your left heel down. Fall in triangle here. The left arm lifts, maybe reaches overhead. Both feet actively pressing down. Yes, 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 yes. Beautiful. Good. Good, Gloria. Uh-huh. Beautiful. And then come elbow and knee, left elbow, right knee together. And then see if you can pivot to your left toes. It's crazy talk. I know. And then three-legged dog. Stretch that right leg back, left hand comes down. Place your right foot forward. And then straighten your right leg. Back heel can be lifted or back heel can be rooted down. That's gonna be your call. So either on the toes or full foot rooted down. One more inhale. Soften the front knee. Take your right hand forward out to the right side. I love a block in this pose. Pushing open, half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. Classical, really beautiful. Both arms are straight. Both legs are working towards straight. If you'd like, bend your left leg. Take your left foot with your left hand and kick away. And as you kick away, keep the belly drawing in so that you're not losing. You're doing great. You're doing great. If you're wondering, if you're curious, you're doing great. If your thoughts are telling you anything other than that, they are lying to you. Your brain is lying to you if it's saying anything other than you are spectacular. Good. If you have the top leg, gently release it. Bend your right knee. See if you can float your right arm up. Stretch the left leg back. Reverse warrior up and back. Maybe your left hand comes behind your back and catches the right thigh. Maybe you lift the right heel and you sink a little deeper. One more inhale. Bring your hands around. Float your right leg back in plank. Take a breath in. Your pathway to down dog. So if you want, lower down, release the foot down. Curl. And then hips high. Really nice. Inhale, left leg back. Left knee to left tricep. Maybe take your left toes to your wrist. And then inhale, up and back. And cross to the right. Extend that left leg out. Turn the right heel down, fall in triangle. Yes. Yep. Good. You got it. Good, Denise. Good. So take this next little challenge with some humor and just slowly. You're going to start to bring the left knee and the right elbow together. And then you start to turn onto the right toes. And then three-legged dog. Stretch the leg back. And then place your foot forward. Grab some blocks under your hands if it's helpful. Straighten both of your legs. Get nice and long in the legs. Get long in the spine. Yes, yes, yes. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Good. One more inhale. And then soften the front knee. Push off the back toes, left hand forward out to the left, and use a block if it helps you. Ardha Chandrasana, half moon. Right leg is lifted, right hand is lifted. Shorten a little bit from your belly button to your pubic bone. So engage that low belly. And then if you want, bend the top leg and reach back for your foot. And then maybe kick the foot into your hand. Yes. Steady your gaze, steady your breath. It doesn't guarantee you balance, but it certainly helps. When I see you again. If you have the foot, stretch the leg back. Bend your left knee. See if you can start to float your left hand off the ground. And then stretch the right leg back. Reverse warrior, take it back. Maybe take that right arm behind the back and catch the left thigh. It's a huge maybe. And then maybe lift the left toes. Heel. Come into the toes and sink a little deeper. Yes. Last inhale. And then bring your hands around. Float the left leg back. Take a breath in plank. And then your pathway to downward facing dog. Good. And then take a pause in downward facing dog. Breathe. If you need a child's pose, bring your knees down and take a child's pose. You're here for about 5 breaths. It is yours to do with as you see fit. Good. Okay, we're gonna take that sequence with some like add-ons. It's gonna move a little faster, but it doesn't mean that your breath is faster. It just means that we're not gonna hold the postures, which sometimes is good news, sometimes not so much, depending on how you feel in the poses and in any given moment. If you need longer, at any time you take it. Come back to down dog when you're ready. Inhale, right leg back. Right knee, right tricep. Maybe tap your wrists with your toes. Inhale, up and back.
And then exhale, cross, fallen triangle. Bring your left elbow, right knee together, come through center, three-legged dog. Place your right foot forward. Straighten both legs, inhale. Now listen, pick up your back heel if it's not. Bend your back legs, keep the front leg straight, sink back. And then push off half moon. Maybe Chapasana taking that foot. Bend the front knee, release the leg. Reach back, reverse warrior. Maybe lift that front heel. And then bring your hands around. Listen, little change, step to plank. Right leg can float if you want. Lower down to your belly. Good. Left elbow out to the side. You're gonna roll open onto your left side. Good. Beautiful. Come back to center, put your right foot down. Bring your left hand in by your ribcage. Take your left foot behind the right leg and then pressing up, wildly. Open up. And then bring your left hand around. Left knee, left tricep. Maybe tap the wrist with your left toes. I know, here we are. Inhale, stretch up and back. Cross over to the right, fallen triangle open. I'm probably gonna screw it up too, don't worry. Come back, elbow, knee come together. Three-legged dog, inhale. Place the left foot forward. Both legs straighten. Lift the right heel. Bend the right knee, the back knee. Sink back. And then push off half moon. Maybe Chapasana. And then bend the front knee. Reverse warrior, take it back. Maybe lift the front heel up. And then bring the hands around. Float the left leg back into plank if it's okay. And then lower down to your belly. Keep that left leg lifted. Right arm out to the side. Bring the left foot behind the right leg. Come back to center. I know this is a tricky transition, but it's actually not. It just is tricky because you haven't seen it before. Bend the right leg. Take the right leg behind the left leg. You're just gonna push. Right hand to the sky. Wide open. Yes! And then right hand, top of the mat. Right knee, right tricep, maybe tap the wrist with your toes. Inhale, stretch back. Right knee, left elbow. Good. Extend the leg. Open up, fallen triangle. Elbow, knee come together through center. Three-legged dog. Place your right foot forward. Little change up, warrior three, lifting off, Virabhadrasana three. Back leg lift. Use your left hip to extend your leg. Yes. Hands come down. Good. Stay in standing splits. This is beautiful. If you want, left knee comes onto your left tricep. You bend your elbow just a little bit on that left arm to give yourself a bit of a shelf. And then your right knee hugs in and maybe extends back. And then as you're ready, make your way back to down dog. Beautiful. Breathe. Just receive all that. Bring your knees down to the ground. We'll do the other side. I know you'll be so sad if we didn't, so don't worry, we will. Come up onto your knees. Bring your hands to your hips. So from belly button to pubic bone, just kind of shorten it a little bit, and then same thing from your sternum to your belly button. So your belly button. So you are containing the front of your body. because it's gonna open no matter what. Rise up, camel. Use your toes, use your feet. Maybe your hands slide to your hamstrings or maybe to your heels. If your hands come to your heels, you're not resting back, you're moving away from the feet. Inhale, rise up. Good, bring your hands forward. And then lower to your belly. Take your right arm out to the side, open up. Keep your left hand where it is, come back to center. Bring your right hand next to your rib cage. Take your right foot behind your left leg. Push down, open up, wild thing. Good. And then bring your right hand around, right knee to right tricep. Inhale up and back. And then cross. Open up. Elbow, knee come together. Three-legged dog. Good. Oh, I did the same side twice. Put your foot down. Oh my gosh, this is tragic. Take your left leg up. We'll never be the same again, ever. Bring your left knee to your left tricep. Tap your wrist. Inhale up and back. And then cross. Extend. Ball and triangle. Yep. We'll never recover from this ever. Come back through center. Good. Elbow, knee. And then three-legged dog. Now place your left foot forward. And then lifting off. Virabhadrasana 3. Use your right glutes to extend that leg behind you. And then hands down. Good, standing splits are perfect. If you want, right knee can come into your tricep, create a little shelf, draw the left knee to your heart, and then maybe extend that leg back. Good, yes. Yes. And then make your way back into downward facing dog, however you want to get there. And then knees down to the ground. Ustrasana again. Opening the heart to the sky. You don't have to go anywhere. This is perfect. This is perfect. Maybe the hands come back to the heels. Lift the heart like crazy. Inhale, rise up. And then child's pose, just come forward. Little pause. Inhale, rise up. Back onto the knees, good. Okay, don't overthink this. Right hand comes to your right heel, your hamstring, or your hip. Open around, and then come back around through center. And then going the other way. Yep, beautiful. And you can just move with your breath here. Mm-hmm, good. You'll finish on the left and then come through center. Forearms come down to the ground. Tuck your toes, come into dolphin. The dolphin is basically, to simplify it as best I can, It's like down dog on your forearms. If you want, step your left foot in closer to your elbows, take your right leg to the sky, and then maybe take a little hop here. Bring your feet down. Bring your knees down. And then come up onto hands and knees. Take a cat's pose, round the back. Take a cow. Pull the heart through. Beautiful. Keep that. Bring the forearms down. Tuck the toes. Dolphin again. If you want, right foot steps in a little closer. Left leg lifts up. And you might just tip forward. Use your hands like crazy. Both feet down, knees down, and child's pose. Really nice. Reconnect to your breath. Up to hands and knees. Bring your right knee forward, your right shin forward. If you need an alternative to pigeon pose, you can take thread the needle or anything else that feels good. So sometimes the pain points in this pose can be the front knee. If you roll onto your right hip and bend the back leg, you usually take away that pain point. So if you feel it in your knee, stop. Make it not hurt. That's what we want, is not being painful, right? That's the correct answer, yes. Yes is the correct answer. Cheat sheet. And then be here however you want. Press the shin down, press the back leg down. If you want to come forward, come forward. If you want to stay upright, stay upright. You don't have to be completely still. You can kind of move in and out of places to find what spot suits you best in this moment. Last two breaths here. And then we're just gonna switch. Bring your hands back in, tuck the back toes. Maybe take a pause into child's pose or down dog, and then come right into the second side as you are ready. Good. Yes. Beautiful. And then take the same process in the side. Sort of scan your body, receive any messages, any feedback the pose is giving you. At the center of our practice is this communication, this internal communication, this listening to your body, noticing your thoughts, noticing your patterns, your reactions. And sometimes we don't want to have that conversation with ourselves, so we wander in our mind and we try to distract ourselves. See how much you can actually tune in here. and then start to rise up again. You can just bend your right leg, extend the legs out, come into a wide leg forward fold. Good. And then maybe come forward. Good. Yeah, you can face any direction you want. So dig the heels down a little into the ground and energetically pull the heels toward the sitting bones. Kind of turn the toes upward, and it's totally fine if the toes fall a little forward. It's not a problem. But turning the toes upward a little bit, asking the hamstrings to do a little bit of work here, and then pressing the backs of the legs back down into the ground and getting a little more extension through the legs, through the spine, through your whole body. Yes. With an inhale, rise. Good. Bring your legs together onto your backs when you're ready. Draw your knees into your chest. Give yourself a little squeeze. And then twisting if it feels good. You can wrap the legs. You can have one knee in, one leg straight. Knees together. Block between your shins or your thighs. Anything that feels good to take a twist. Go whatever direction you want to go. Come back to center and switch your twist. And then back to center and Shavasana. Release your legs out. Turn your palms to the sky. Allow your shoulders to drop heavy into the ground, your head, your hips, calves, heels. Consciously, mindfully invite stillness and quiet into your being. And then just let go. Allow your breath to deepen. Take a gentle scan of your body. So, like moving slowly, maybe starting to move gently with hands and feet, wrists and ankles. And then reach your arms overhead and stretch long. So, take the arms away from the feet away from the arms. And catch your knees into your chest if it feels good, or just bend your knees on the ground, whichever one is better for you. Mm-hmm. Or knees bent, feet on the ground, that's a better description. From here, you can either roll to your side, rise to sitting from there, or rock up to sitting and sit comfortably. Just find your way there in a way that suits you today. If you can, keep your eyes soft, maybe closed. Trust your movements. And once you're seated, bring your hands in prayer together at your heart. Honor you showed up on your mat today. I'm so thankful that you did. And I'm glad you shared your practice with me. So thanks for being here. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow your mind to your heart. Rise with an inhale, eyes open gently. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a brilliant day. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks for being here.